Johnny!
I'm sorry I'm late.
Why do they keep you around?
Right away. Right away.
You're late.
I am so sorry. I'm new here.
Why do they keep you around?
Please give me a chance. I can do better.
You're late.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
On the desk.
I'll do my best.
Did you hear it? We have a crisis on our hands. Yes, rather serious, actually. Helen, Miss Marshall, called in sick today. She was taken to the hospital. We don't know if she's coming back. Miss Marshall really is important. But only the director's secretary ever runs in his name. Who's going to do it today? He's been waiting for his name all day, but no one's stepping up. Honestly, I'd hate to be here when the director realizes his mail isn't coming.
Get moving.
I'm on it. I'm sorry.
I can fix it.
I'll try harder.
Fine. Get out of here.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're dismissed.
Anything for the Bureau.
You've got something.
I am so sorry. I'm new here. Happen again, I promise.
That'll be all.
Thank you for giving me a chance.
You're dismissed.
No problem.
That'll be all.
Glad to be of assistance.
Good help these days.
I'm sorry, sir.
It's on the desk.
I'll get it done right now.
Pick it up.
Yes, ma'am.
She was taken to hospital.
But only the director's secretary.
I'm on it.
Are you sure you are not lost? Maybe you can find yourself in the director's office.
Oh, great. I was just waiting for my mail. Just leave it on the desk there, please. See, you're the new girl, right? Welcome to the Bureau. We're glad to have you on board. And you should be proud. We do very important work here. Oh, and don't worry about starting at the bottom. I wasn't always the director, you know. My Bureau career began as a lowly agent. Those were the days. I never dreamed I'd one day be sitting here, an old man, in this big chair, like they say, when you're pushed upwards, you end up out of your comfort zone. Please, take the outgoing mail as well. Thank you. Very good. You better run along now. I have a lot of work to do. Important Bureau business.
Oh, of course. Right away. Thank you, Mr. Director.
What? What is happening? I don't like this. No, this isn't me. I'm not me. I can't. Why can't I feel you? Something I can't think. Oh, I'm lost. Where are you? I can't feel anything. I don't want to be alone here. Where am I? What is this? Why won't it end? Wake up, please. I want to go home.
Pick it up.
You should keep trying. You are getting closer.
I need to go inside. I need to keep moving.
Mr. Faden, the new director? Oh, yeah. Very handsome. With Helen gone as well, he'll be needing a new secretary, don't you think? They say he is very smart as well. Oh, it'd be great to have someone in charge who can really put the Bureau back on the map.
He can't find good help these days.
You're late.
I've got nothing more for you.
That'll be all.
You're dismissed.
Don't let it go to your head.
Fine. Now get out of here.
You're dismissed. Why do they keep you around?
Fine. Get out of here. That'll be all. You can't find good help these days. Something.
Don't let it go to your head.
I've got nothing more for you.
Doesn't she know how dangerous the old director is? He's unstable. Heart.
She took the director's mail. That's evidence against the director. Is she helping him out?
She's going to the old director's office. They must be working together. She must be in on it.
Been invaded. I must act. I have a plan. An answer. I'll take the slide projector to the nostalgia department. I'll turn it on. I'll bring the hiss in. I'll fix this. I can hear them plotting against me. We've been invaded, corrupted. I've lost Darling. He was the first to go. He's been exposed to Hedron's resonance. It controls him now. It controls everyone who wears the amplifier device. I ordered them not to use the damn things. They didn't listen. Hedron corrupted the Bureau. They'll never be people again. They're either dead or they're monsters. I'll stop them. I have a secret ally. The Nostalgia Department. I have my own slide for the projector. I took it. A memento. In ordinary. After the girl burned them. It's burnt, but it'll work. The hiss will save us all. I lost my train of thought. It's confused. Like somebody, you know, switching channels too fast. I see so much, but it's too fast. On the expedition through the slide, something got into my ear, and it hurt at first. But then it didn't. It started as a distant whisper, like something you hear in a dream, like a faraway voice calling you to wake up. I'd open my eyes with those words still on my lips. See, in the dream, they had made perfect sense, but awake, they're like a foreign language, already forgotten. Then the sense of loss hits, like losing a child, like losing yourself. You see, I was being taught a song, a poem, a prayer that would light up my world and make me break through, make all this pain worth it. Something once lost was found, and it made a home in me. A spring with, like, waves carving me and making me see. And it grew until it filled me. And I receded deeper into myself, into this office, locked in this oldest house, which is my aging body. I stared in awe through the peephole, and I was filled with knowledge and made better. You know, I often feel like I'm being watched. Yeah, like there's someone watching me. They can see me, but I can't see them. I remember it was like this dream I had last night. See, there was this man here in this very room. And then, well, sometimes he was a plumber unclogging the drain, and then, well, because there was a fish stuck there. Yeah, a big fish. But sometimes he was an old god, you see, and he had put the fish there in the first place to keep the waste. There was rising waste from leaking out. So he was he was conflicted, but he knew many things. But he was also sort of senile, like me. It was more like a riddle or an omen. It wasn't a very good one or an interesting one, but I get so confused so easily. It's so very hard to follow everything that's happening.
I won't let them win. That's how it happened. The hiss got Trench first. He turned on the projector. He let them in. I have to remember the hiss. The hiss is the enemy. This is all inside my head. The hiss burrowing in. I'm trapped in here. They're taking over. Doing this anymore.
I need to get to Trench's office.
Welcome back. I knew I chose a good assistant.
I will fight this. I will find a way to push them out.
You are a worm. Time.
I need my gun.
Death out of time. Breaking words first.
Start at the beginning. I should have seen it earlier. This is my mess to clean up. My fight. No one else's. I am the director.
Hello. This is Dr. Casper Darling. I have a classified message for the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. I have sad news. Hedren is gone now, but it was not a source. It was a catalyst. Do you understand? You must go to my office, the endgame. It will be revealed.
I can't feel you. I can't. This is what Dylan wanted all along. But there's something. I can feel it, but I don't know what. The motel is a place of power, of change, a place to pass through, connecting everything. This is a dream inside my head. Why shouldn't it take me anywhere I want to go? This is so weird. It is my head. You are such a weirdo, Jesse. Grow brighter around one constant. They revolve. Hedron is dead, but you're alive here in me. Maybe Hedron put you in our heads when we met her. Maybe you were always there, and she was just trying to teach me how to trigger you. Maybe I'll never understand. Maybe I don't need to. Trench was the first to be corrupted by the hiss. Slowly, over the years. His need for control only made it worse. It was Trench who took the projector to the nostalgia department. He opened the door to the hiss. Just like that. With Hedron dead, the hiss tried to corrupt me too. But I'm stronger than them. We're stronger. They're waiting. They'll try to stop us.
My sister had this dream, a bad dream, and the whole world was dreaming with her.
Dylan?
She convinced herself that she was awake. She's always been stubborn. I knew I had to end her dream. I had to wake her up. I had to rip down poster she'd been staring at. Cut off her eyelids to make her see. To save her.
He's still there somewhere.
locked inside. I know, because that's how it was for me.
Thank you. your boss! Your boss! You!
Dylan's in a coma. I don't know if there's anything of him left in there. If he'll ever find his way back. The portal's been closed, but the hiss is still in the oldest house. And the lockdown can't be lifted as long as any trace of it remains. I'm working on a solution with my management team, but there is still a long road ahead. I'm the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. We're in this together. You and I.
reflection trapped in the darkness of the coffee I nurse. The rain turned the lights of the city into a mosaic on the windows. The day's paper lists all the things wrong in the world. The list grows longer by the day. The difference between the morning and the night, coffee, whiskey, no other difference. The alarm goes off at 5 a.m. It feels like I just closed my eyes. It's dark. I sit up on the bed in the gloom. I get up, I shower. The driver waits for me downstairs, takes me to the oldest house. An old man stares at me in the car window. It's raining. It's dark. Late at night, he brings me back here. It's not a home. It's a room where I sleep in, waking up just as tired as I was before going to bed. Endless grind.
Attitude.